This video tutorial is a general overview that shows you new features and functionality for SmartConsole in R80.10 deployments. Today, we are explaining the security policy view that you can use to manage access control and threat prevention. A quick glance at the network deployment. R80.10 Security Management Server, R80.10 Security Gateways, and SmartConsole runs on a Windows PC. When it comes to cybersecurity, R80.10 SmartConsole is the premier management solution and includes a unified security policy that lets you manage multiple access control blades in a single rule base. One policy for IPS and other threat prevention blades. Zone-based policies, where you can use inline layers to create sub-policies for different network segments. The security policies view shows the access control and threat prevention rule bases. Starting with R80.10, you can configure rules for these blades in a single rule base. Firewall, application control and URL filtering, content awareness, and mobile access. For example, let's take a look at Rule 5. The Services and Applications column is set to match URLs that are high risk. The Content column matches traffic that downloads executable files. The Action is set to Drop. This is a sample rule that blocks users from downloading executable files from high-risk websites. You can use inline layers to create zone-based policies. An inline layer is basically a sub-policy. Let's take a closer look at the rules in the inline layer that manage access to the servers in the data center. The action for Rule 10 is the data center inline layer. This means that Rule 10 is the parent rule for the data center sub-policy. The rules in this inline layer use content awareness and data types to control how files are transferred to and from the data center servers. Configuring the inline layer does not change how the firewall enforces other rules in the ordered layer for the security policy. The firewall only applies rules 10.1 to 10.6 on traffic that matches Rule 10. For traffic that does not match Rule 10, the firewall continues to inspect the connection according to Rule 11. Finally, the cleanup rule drops traffic to these servers that does not match one of these rules. You can use the Logs tab to easily show the matching logs for each rule. To see the log data, right-click a log and select Open. With R80.10, you can also use the IP search feature. Searching the rule base lets you not only find the relevant network objects, but also networks and groups that they belong to. Now we move on to the Unified Threat Prevention Policy, which controls these features: IPS, anti-bot, antivirus, threat emulation, and threat extraction. SmartConsole has these features to help manage IPS protections. Predefined IPS tags let you easily filter protections that are related to a category, such as vendor, protocols, or product. Revision control for IPS updates lets you revert only the IPS package. The rest of the management server settings are not changed. By default, new IPS protections are set to detect in staging mode. After you review the new protections, you can select clear staging to activate them. In this video, we looked at an overview of the security policies view in the R80.10 SmartConsole. We saw unified policies for access control and threat prevention, one threat prevention policy for multiple blades. One access rule also enforces application control and content awareness. Use the IP address to search for rules and objects. New IPS features, tags, and revision control for IPS packages. Thanks for watching and have a great day.